off. The three of us can take a little vacation before you head off to law school. Maybe get a break in the case. And you wait here. Nick?
Laura, there's been an accident.
Dad couldn't find my house. The key, I think I left it at the bar.
How much have you had to drink?
Break-in, Chief. Window over there is smashed. Best we can figure is it was a burglary gone wrong. Vic came into the kitchen, scared him in the act. They panicked.
Oh, Laura, I'm so sorry. There's no jewelry. Looks like they yanked it right off of her neck. She has a daughter, Natalie. So I should probably call her and break the bad news.
Sir, My Rose got her out back right now. She was upstairs when it happened. She's the one that called in.
I want to report on my desk ASAP. Make sure you get a picture of the neck and the wrist.
Yes, sir.
And what time did you go to bed last night?
I don't remember because I wasn't feeling very well.
And as far as you know, did your mother have any plans for last night? Was she going to have anybody else over?
No, she didn't talk to anybody like that since... Oh my God, Nick, thank God you're here. You have to find out who did this. I mean, who would do this to her?
No. Monroe?
Chief, I just have a few more questions for her and then
I would appreciate it if you'd go and ask the neighbors some questions. See if they have anything to add. I can't even begin to imagine what you're going through. But if you're up for it, you know, any little detail may very well help us catch who killed her. The car isn't here. Is it possible that...
I walked home. I'd had a bit to drink. My mom let me in and then we talked for a bit and then I went to bed.
After that, did you hear anything? Any noises? Any voices?
I guess I'd had a little bit more than a little bit to drink.
You have somebody to call? Someplace safe that you can go to?
I could call Ethan, but...
Don't worry. I know the folks that own this Lincoln City. I'll put you up. Until I know who did this. I promise.
All alone. No, you're not. But
bet what you probably are is hungry. So come to the bar. I've got a shift, and I know that you could use a drink over price. There's no rum in that one, it's because there isn't. We don't want a repeat of last week, do we, Norris? And speaking of unwelcome repeats,
where is she, Shelby?
Not here. Not neither should you be.
A lot of me.
Okay. You're a creep, and you should leave.
Her car's outside, Shelby. You can't try.
Because she's walked home, just like you should. Okay, don't want to wreck that pretty little car of yours.
My phone wants.
Your phone? Okay. You're right. I was wrong. You're not a creep. You're a super creep. And you don't work here, so get out behind the bar.
I just want to make sure she's okay.
Of course she's not. Her mother died.
I want her to know that I'm here for her.
Chief, it's good to see you.
Just paying my respects.
I know what's up.
Okay, what's up?
You're looking for the killer. I heard they always come to the victim's funeral.
Yeah, I don't think that's true.
Well, don't worry, I'll stand. Think you could do me a favor, Chief?
Who's the guy in the car?
Ethan, Natalie's ex, super creeper. And look where he is. Just saying.
I got him.
My name's Sharon with you. So is this an everyday look for you? No, not that you look bad. I mean, you look really beautiful. Just...
It's my mother's funeral today.
I'm sorry.
It's okay, you didn't know.
Still, I'm sorry, Natalie. Do they serve good apologies here?
I never told you my name.
You didn't? Huh. Well, I think Rudy said it was Natalie, was it? No? Oh, then what is it? I know who you are, but if you'll just listen to me. My name is Brody. Brody Long. I'm a writer. A crime writer. I'd really like to talk about everything that's been going on. I knew your father. Before he died, I was writing a book about the case he was working on. My Zotti family ties to organized crime. I reached out to your mother.
Oh, but now they're dead, so you need a new source to exploit?
No, I want to help. If you just hear me out. Look, I know you have no reason to trust me. Trust this. You're in danger.
Stay away from me. Right there. She set it away from the phone. I don't think she realized it would be picked up by the recording.
Monroe, people react to trauma in all kinds of ways. You can't take "I'm sorry" as an admission of guilt.
There's more. Some drawers were open, some were dumped out on the ground, and then there's this table lying on its side. But what's weird here are the chairs. If someone was looking for something and panicked, it would have been impulsive, so the chairs would have scattered when the table was flipped, but these look like they've been pulled out.
You are suggesting that this is staged.
The only items that are missing are a wedding ring and a necklace, both on her person. No other attempt to loot the house.
Maybe that's when he was interrupted.
Or she.
You heard what Natalie said. Hell, we knew Laura. And the woman was harmless. If you can see a motive beyond her big house and a nice car, then I'd appreciate it if you'd share it.
It just seems odd that Natalie didn't hear anything. If a table is thrown across the room... It's kind of hard not to hear it.
She was drunk.
And that makes her less of a suspect? Look, I know you have a personal relationship with this family, but this is worth pursuing. It may be nothing, but I have questions.
Okay.
Nick, did you find him?
No, not yet. I just wanted to check on you.
Yeah, my phone's been off. I'm not really in a chatty mood.
I understand that. Well, I'm sorry that I can't be the bearer of good news, but I can be the bearer of lunch. It's from Rudy's, so...
Thank you for this.
Possibility.
my mom never believed that. She said the Manzanis were the kind of people that could shut somebody up if they wanted to.
None of us believed that your dad had started drinking again. But the toxicology report was pretty clear. I'm not trying to upset you. We need to get into the future. And we don't do that by dwelling in the past, do we? So you do me a favor and you stay in the present.
Astray. You went to Rudy's at about 6 p.m. not for work, but for a drink with friends. And at 9:15, you walked home where you were greeted on the front porch by your mother, and you two had a fight.
Well, I wouldn't say it was a fight.
We spoke with your neighbor, Betty Ledbetter, and she stated that you were yelling so loudly she could hear you from across the street.
You had an argument, right?
Did you have these arguments regularly?
What does this have to do with the break-in?
It doesn't.
You were the last person to see her alive. The details of that interaction are extremely pertinent. Did you recently come back from a trip, a vacation? Were you planning one?
No.
You had a suitcase out in your room. It was hurriedly packed from the looks of it. You didn't have any plans. What were you packing for?
I don't think I want to answer any more questions right now.
Idea.
Yeah, I know it seems weird, but I read that the healthiest thing to do is separate yourself from material residue. What does that even mean?
I'm not sure. Look, there is a lot of stuff in this house, and with it sitting here empty,
what if the robber comes back? So you agree that it's a robber? Because the police don't seem sure.
I mean, yeah, who else would it be? Who do they think it is?
They don't know.
Well, that's the problem with the police. Never sure.
What was that?
Someone's in here. I heard that criminals often return to them. Okay, we're calling the police.
No. Wait.
Suspect.
named them. Now, I don't have a suspect either, but I do have a weapon. Your mom was a big reader, right? I figured. Great collection. And what's missing from this bookshelf?
What? One of your books? What's that?
This is a start.
There were two of these.
Obviously.
But good. What about Brody? The case
case was cold and he had to force it to reopen.
The police? Maybe my mom proved that they botched the investigation on my dad. Could be embarrassing.
Would Nick allow that?
I don't know, we're open to every possibility, right?
Okay. Me. Your mom was trying to convince you to go to law school, and I would have missed you too much.
Or me.
Inheritance?
What? No, I was gonna say drunk and fight, but is that what you think? Is that why you wanted to play this game?
No, I wasn't. It's just a stupid game.
Yeah, it's really stupid. And it's probably just a robber.
Maybe.
I mean, who else could it be?
You know, it's just really hard to say. I only wish I'd paid a bit more attention. I think I told you before, I always felt like a real closeness to that family.
Yeah, you mentioned that.
Not like I was actually a part of it. I mean, Laura was her mother, and let me tell you, she was a saint.
Yep, you mentioned that.
The way Manly would speak to her sometimes, I would never. But I can't. You wrote that down, right?
Yep.
You got it?
Got it all right here.
I wish I could help. I really do. But I think she always found me kind of annoying.
Find that hard to believe. Anyways, thank you so much for your time.
Oh, my pleasure.
If you do find that copy of my book, I'd be happy to come back and sign it for you.
Absolutely.
Always nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Good luck.
Afternoon, Mrs. Ledbetter.
Chief Nick, nice to see you. Is Navi doing all right?
Oh, all things considered. Betty, I had a few follow-up questions, but if you don't mind me asking, who's that?
Oh, him? Oh, he's a true crime novelist. In town covering Laura Romero's murder. Seems a little sweet on Natalie. You know, he knew Mr. Romero. Apparently, he was working on a book about him, too. Really hope this book's better than his last. It was a real snooze fest, you know?
Excuse me. Had the nosy neighbor only been as attentive through the night as she was to the fight, might she have... Problem, Chief?
No, no. Maybe. Did you know that you could be charged with obstruction of justice for threatening or interfering with the witnesses of an ongoing investigation?
I'm just asking questions.
For your book?
For my book.
See, that's the thing. This murder isn't a story. It is an entertainment. A lot of people were hurt by it. People that... exploit that pain. Making myself clear, right?
I think so. I think we want the same thing here, for justice to be served, to honor Andy Romero.
I want the same thing. See, you want to protect your Amazon sales. I want to protect grieving survivors from your harassment. What I don't want is to see you around this town again.
Ethan, what are you doing?
What are you telling the police about me?
Nothing.
They came to talk to me. They wanted to know where I was the night your mother died.
They're talking to everyone that's connected.
So now I'm connected.
You were with me then.
Don't lie to me, Natalie.
Everything okay?
So I guess it's you. I guess you're what needing space looks like. Well, I hope she's warned you, buddy, but people that get close to her, they don't last very long. Better you than me. Good luck.
Good?
Yeah.
I assume he's the suspect, right?
And now he's been threatening me.
Threatening you? How so?
I mean, he showed up at my motel. He showed up in my car. I thought you said you were going to talk to him.
I did. He's not the most stand-up guy, but he has an alibi for the time of death, and it checks out. So as far as we're concerned, he's not a suspect. But if you feel threatened...
No, it's okay. Thank you for your time.
Actually, Natalie, I'm glad you stopped by. There's something I wanted to run by you.
Hey, well, do I need a lawyer?
You're entitled to one if you want. It's up to you.
No, it's fine. What is it?
I've been reviewing your statement, and you said that you came home and went straight to bed. Is that correct?
I mean, I packed a little bit. I was upset. You know that?
Of course. And then you woke up the next morning, and you went downstairs and found your mom, right? Do you recognize this room? And do you see what's here on the nightstand?
The glass of water?
You see, what's weird about this glass of water is that it's fresh. There's still condensation on it.
I don't understand.
If you went straight to bed, how do you explain this glass of water?
I don't know. I was really drunk. Maybe I went down to the kitchen. I was really drunk. I don't really...
You don't remember? Right. Look, I'm just trying to get your story straight. If you don't remember going downstairs for a glass of water, I'm just curious what else you might not remember seeing or doing.
Me again while you're not on this case.
Your ex-boyfriend. Again.
Still stuck on that?
She's trying to throw us. Now hear me out. I asked her about the glass of water, and just like the suitcase, she had nothing.
Neither do we.
That is not true. Anyone can tell that scene was staged, and nothing that this girl has said adds up. We need to start seriously investigating the possibility that Natalie Romero is her mother's murderer.
Yeah, I know. Thank you.
Hey, Natalie. I was gonna leave.
Somebody you need to see.
Where are these?
You're not the only one with investigative skills.
Wait. Detective Monroe was the officer on scene the night your father died? It's a hell of a coincidence.
Or is it? Go to the last page. Toxicology.
Redacted?
Yeah, entirely.
What are the legal ramifications? I thought you were in law school. Your dad mentioned that you were prepping for your LSATs. You passed, I assume.
It was over a year ago. Look, you're right. I can't just sit with my hands tied while the police are just connecting all the wrong dots. What do I do?
You connect the right ones. Let's go. When you're writing, you gotta try and get in the heads of all your characters. The same way police want to get in the heads of criminals, and we want to get in the heads of police. We want to know what they're thinking, and we want to know why.
The police think the crime scene was staged.
Very good. How can you tell?
Because I heard them say it at the station. And because the drawers were all open and there was nothing taken other than what was on her, this table was flipped. I mean, how would that even happen?
Exactly. See?
Thank you.
assailant? Identifying marks?
No. His face was covered.
With this, right?
Yeah. I cut his arm, though, and it was pretty deep.
No blood. Scene's clean.
Natalie, have you been drinking tonight?
Excuse me?
I'm sorry, but I have to ask.
Well, I have to ask, too. Why don't you start treating her like the victim that she is instead of a suspect? She was almost just killed, no thanks to your handy police work.
She'll be.
Natalie, what were you doing in there all along?
What does it matter?
I'm on your side here.
Are you? Because it's kind of starting to feel like maybe you're not.
Natalie, I got you a room so that you wouldn't have to be here.
Thank you. I think I'm going to head there right now, actually. Shall we?
Gladly. I think you need to take a look inside.
Shirt you're wearing the night of the murder.
How'd you know that?
I watched the surveillance footage at the bar.
God, there's cameras everywhere now, isn't there?
Yeah. Yeah, there are.
So this was stuck in the window frame, which is the point of entry, but we know it isn't.
No, I would have seen it.
So would the police. If someone's trying to frame me, they're not gonna fall for it, right?
I don't know, they seem to be missing a lot lately. I talked to Mrs. Ledbetter, your neighbor. Every question they were asking her was leading. They basically wanted her to say that you were off. But she didn't, though. She seems to really care. And because you're not awful.
No, I am. I was awful that night. It's just so frustrated and confused and sad. I feel guilty even though I didn't.
I get it.
I know, everyone says they get it, everyone says they understand, but you can't understand unless...
Unless you've been through it yourself. I lost both my parents in a car accident when I was 19.
I'm so sorry.
The last thing I said to him was that I wouldn't pay for the window I broke when I was mad about a rejection letter. I came here looking for a story. That's true. I feel a real connection to you. I don't know, that sounds weird, but I mean, I feel like I knew exactly what you were feeling. The loneliness and the confusion, the guilt.
Everything I want to say to you right now sounds kind of like the annoying stuff everyone was saying to me.
Well, maybe some of them are right.
Yeah, doesn't make it easier to hear.
But sometimes we have to hear it. When I interviewed your father, he talked about you. Now, this may be hard to hear, but I think it might make things easier, too.
Thank you.
Rhodes made him distress people, I wonder who he was talking about.
That's what I intend to find out.
Thank you for helping me. I feel like it's been really hard, but having you here is kind of made me feel like I can get through it.
I feel like my dad was definitely wrong about one thing.
What's going on?
That's my car. Detective, what are you doing?
Nellie, I need you to stay back.
Do you have a search warrant?
I don't understand.
Detective, I have something here.
Recognize this?
That's just a bookend.
Natalie Romero, you were under arrest for the murder of your mother, Laura Romero. You have the right to remain silent. Put your hands behind your back.
Please.
Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford one, one will be appointed for you.
Do you understand the rights as I have read them to you?
Natalie, no matter what.
Thank you. just wondering if you turn up anything new.
I'm sorry. Who are you?
Oh, how rude. Greg. Greg Wilson. Anyway, I know how annoying you must be when people play amateur detective, but my wife's been dying to know if you turn up anything on those tapes.
I'm sorry. Let's, just pretend that I'm new to this case. Which tapes are we talking about?
Oh, I'm sorry. I live just down the street. I told the other officer my camera doesn't see the Romero house. Just the street. But he said they might be valuable anyway, to paint a full and vibrant picture. Guy had a pretty good vocabulary for a cop. Actually, sounded more like a writer. I hope I didn't offend you.
You've been extremely helpful. It's just that other officer is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Okay, look, I'm the first to admit it. I haven't always been a nice guy.
Except you didn't admit it, so what do you want to show me?
I used to have some anger issues. I'm not going to say it's you know, from what happened to my parents, but you know where I'm coming from, right?
Anger? Yeah, I'm familiar with the emotion. What do you want to show me?
Yeah, of course. I just want to make sure we're cool.
Or not.
Wait. All right, look. Remember how I said the cops talked to your neighbors?
Yeah, Mrs. Ledbetter?
Right. And I talked to the neighbor next door to her. Guess what?
What is this?
The night of the murder.
Does it show anything?
I don't know. Shall we?
Car.
He was there.
He let it play. the last place I saw my mother alive. I was really mean to her. And I blame myself, but I shouldn't. Because somebody took her.
Natalie, you said that you had no evidence to show me.
Thank you.
we really could have used his sixth sense for stalking Natalie. What are you doing?
He doesn't have a sixth sense. He has a tracking app.
A tracking app?
That's how insecure people date these days.
No passcode, idiot. Sorry. South Shore, Burning Bay.
What's there?
Just marsh. It's where the Manzottis used to.
Everyone said I shouldn't. Even you said it.
say about what you're doing?
I haven't told her any of the details, but she disapproves. Thinks it's a waste of time. The truth is, Nellie and I have been going through a bit of a rough patch.
And now you.
Why couldn't you just let this be?
Because it's in my blood.
That's too bad. Sorry, Andy.
So it could be the title of the last chapter.
Totally.
And why didn't I get to be in it anywhere? I drove you to the finale.
Yeah, how did you get there in the book?
He drives Ethan's Camaro. Hey, why didn't you drive his Camaro there?
I maybe sort of don't know how to drive a stick.
Somebody ordered Rudy's?
I did that for you. Thank you.
Stuff while you're away at school.
Yeah, you were right about these fries. Better get some before I take them all.
Hey, this is for you.
Thanks, Miss Leather.
You're quite welcome.
More like my best. Here you go.
Thank you.
Not that drunk.
You okay?